12 o'clock on a Wednesday and this is the Wizard Product Review. I'm Dave.
I'm Wayne.
And on this week's show you will notice that Blammo is back to full health. He's had the clearance from the vet, he's back to full health.
Yay!
Fake sound effects. Yay! Cheering. There we go. Still recovering. We're still being nice to him.
He was born.
What you been doing this week, Wayne, before we get on with the
talk? Went away for a weekend.
You went away? Where'd you go?
This beautiful marina.
Very nice.
Lovely, mate.
Very nice.
Great, great time. Bit of a there's such a thing as too good a time.
Right. Is there?
Yeah. Can't remember anything else that happened that weekend. Just a load of thingy.
Okay. Did you do any magic jobs or anything like that? Can I tell you about this wedding exhibition I did?
Yeah, go on.
I did a wedding exhibition, quite a big wedding exhibition. It's pretty much the only one that I do in my area.
Yeah.
And there was this other magician there. Not Stephen, who I know, that does this act like the mystery guest, is mostly mind reading. He's a good guy. But there was this magician. He was on a photo booth stand, and I call him a magician. He didn't legitimately have a stand there. And he was on this photo booth stand, helping the guy out from the photo booth. Mm-hmm. And he came over to me and he was like, yeah, can't see any point in all this sleight of hand stuff. I don't do any clever stuff. I just do double cross and that kind of thing. And then we found out, myself and Stephen, that he was there illegally at the wedding exhibition.
Oh, lovely.
And not only that, he'd been on his stand actually complaining about our prices, saying he would do it less than half our prices. And he didn't even have a stand. I've yet to find out the name of this person.
I was just about to say name,
but
that's an awful thing.
The investigation is continuing. I'm trying to find out who it is. Maybe you know who it is. Maybe you can get in touch and send me some information. So there you go. Anyway, Magic Circle Close-Up Magician of the Year tonight, on the day that we're filming.
Yeah.
You'll also be in Manchester tonight doing
lecturing
a lecture.
Tonight, yeah.
I'm going to tag along as well, but that will be all been and gone by the time the Wizard Product Review is going live. You have a new product for Blackpool.
I do, mate. Yes. Little secret. I'm not going to tell you. I'm not going to tell you, but so do you.
I have a new product for Blackpool as well, but I'm not going to tell you. It's a little bit of a secret until the next Wizard Product Review.
You little
and
tease.
Then we will reveal all. What can I say? What can you got? Okay, say a little bit about yours, just a little bit.
Same shot.
Yeah,
it's too heavy for me to push out the way.
Right. Okay. Right. Shall I do mine?
You do yours.
Mine. I'll do mine. And it's nothing to do with constipation.
Oh.
Right, okay. So that's the little... And it's a custom-made gimmick, and there will only ever be 60 at Blackpool. And that's it.
I know, you are, aren't you, as well?
There'll only be 60 at Blackpool. That's it. Got quotes from Chris Angel, Ryan Trix, all sorts of people that have seen this effect already in Vegas, where I filmed the trailer. It will be out of Blackpool, but there is only 60. First review this week is by Taiwan Ben. Are we calling it Bont or Boint?
I think it's Boint.
Okay, I'm not sure. But basically, it is a coin-in-bottle system. If you're familiar with something called Corker, that was out many years ago, which was a beautifully made version of a gimmicked cork that was used in a coin-in-bottle routine to introduce the gimmick into the coin-in-bottle routine without any palming, without any switching. So literally, you can... show a coin in a bottle.
It made the whole thing a lot
show
more
the bottle.
Accessible.
You can take the cork. That's the only way into the bottle. You then put the cork in and you hold it in your hand, but you can introduce a coin into the bottle using the normal sort of coins available from Tango and people like that. The fact that this cork was so brilliant, it was so well made, is actually a little bit of a game changer. I know there was something in the Michael Amar book that described this special cork, the Corker gimmick, that was the name of the product, but they made it so well, it had like a brass lining and that kind of thing. What Taiwan Ben has done is taken that same thinking, but applied it to a modern day presentation.
Yeah, exactly.
So describe what the trick looks like. Wayne.
So exactly what that is, you take a borrowed bottle, a plastic bottle that someone's drinking from.
So like a water bottle, Coke bottle.
Yep, empty it, put the lid back on it, and they get to hold it in their hand. You can take a coin, smash it into the side or into the bottom of the bottle while they're holding it, and the coin penetrates into the plastic bottle.
So it's a classic coin in bottle plot, but the gimmick that you get in here, it makes it a lot easier to introduce that coin into the bottle. Very cleanly, you can get the gimmick coin into the bottle just as easy as putting the lid on, just like the original Corker routine. It comes in three different styles. You can get a black one, you can get a white one, like a Coke Zero style, or you can get the red one. So you need to think about which style you go for. You get the normal bottle cap, and you also get the gimmicked bottle cap, which behaves in exactly the same way as the original cork gimmick.
I was really, really very pleasantly surprised. I really, when you was, we were talking about it before, I actually saw the gimmick. I didn't think they were going to be so well made. And they really, really are.
Yeah, it's kind of like Skycap quality built. Yeah, if you imagine that original Skycap gimmick, you know, the quality of the caps is just the same, but it's got that corker style gimmick to it as part of the cap. We did try it with a Tango coin. We only had a water bottle in the house, didn't we? Now, the problem with a water bottle is it goes straight round in like a curve like this at the bottom. And it's very difficult to shake out the coin. So we both felt that maybe when you've got the real funnel-shaped bottles like Coke bottles, that's going to be a lot easier to shake out the coin at the end of the routine.
Yeah.
We couldn't try that because we actually wanted to demonstrate it on the show. We had the we had the gimmick coin here available to do the whole thing, but you can't actually shake it out afterwards, so without a lot of force and a lot of trial and error. Certainly Taiwan Ben has no problem with that on the tutorial, and literally every single time he's shaking it and it goes out. It's a good gimmick, isn't
it?
If you're familiar with the
corker
principle, I don't want to give too much away. It's basically a modern day version of that. If you want to do the coin in a bottle, in a plastic bottle, I firmly believe there's no better way to do it than this gimmick at the moment.
It's so, it feels impromptu. It's that kind of stuff. I talk about this in my lecture tonight. It's about being ready all the time. It's something you can just easily put in your ticket pocket on your jeans and have there the whole time until someone says to you, the magicians, do some magic for us. And you're not just going to do something that you was doing years ago. You're going to do something really current and really fresh, and it's going to be really hard hitting. Brilliant stuff.
Quite often at events as well, I find myself in like a green room area or something like that, where they've got bottles of water around. I love the idea of like a mini presentation where you're kind of doing like a small illusion. You take one of those water bottles. There's no holes in it because obviously the water's not coming out. The only hole is this one.
Yeah.
Take the cap off, do the necessary, pour the water out, then put the cap back on, and then bang the coin in the bottle. It's absolutely unbelievable. If you present that the right way, it's like a mini illusion. Mm. I really like this. The gimmick is great. It's only a 30-minute tutorial with Ben just talking straight to camera, but you do see some live performances as well. It's all you'll ever need. I think he filmed it in a marina as well, actually.
I think he did. It was a marina.
Yeah. How much are you going to give it?
I'm going to give it 90%.
I'm going to give it 95%. It's better than that. 95%. Retrieve by S Magic Productions is our second review. It's kind of like a system, if you like, a system to put something on a card case. Tap it with a pen, because that's what you want to be able to do as the greatest magician in the world. Tap things with a biro and make them change.
Yeah.
That's going to really get you some bookings, that is. So, but there's no doubt, when you see the effect, it does look good, doesn't it, on the video?
Oh, yeah, there's no doubt about it. It does look very, very good. Put something on there, give it a tap with a pen, and it changes or vanishes. I think it does look very nice.
It reminds me very much of something that we reviewed on the Wizard Product Review some time ago called Froggy, which was actually a system for having a folded card in full view. And I bet you could use this gimmick when you've made it to do the same thing. And then at the end of your card routine, you would MCF the card and then reach down and pick up that folded card. And it would be the spectator's sign card. You would definitely be able to do this because the gimmick is almost identical. Mm. It's very similar to a thing that Michael Chatelain has done. But they're selling it under this effect of making something change in the action of tapping it with a pen. So it's not really a covert device for switching something. In one of the effects, for example, they've got a very mini post-it note. He draws a butterfly on there, and a little plastic butterfly appears when he just taps it on top, and it just changes. There's ideas with corners of playing cards and that kind of thing. My only thing is, I don't think when you've made it yourself, and you do need to construct this gimmick, How long was he? Did he take to do it? And bear in mind, this is the creator, yeah, right?
He was on there.
And
you get,
as well as the DVD, you get the envelope full of all the bits to make your special gimmick card case and your download link. And you literally sat with this guy for half hour while I don't mind saying, I'm not embarrassed to say, I would mess this thing up. Mm. There was too much. You only get like one of everything to do it. So if you're screwing it up, you're screwing up your gimmick.
You can easily, in my opinion, you will be getting this wrong. You'll be sticking stuff down and thinking, oh, that shouldn't be on there, and peeling things off.
It was not easy very to hard follow. To follow. Yeah, it was not easy to follow. The gimmick itself, if it was all made, I'd be giving it a better review. Mm. If it was all made up and folded up and in the card case. And that was the case with the froggy effect. A strange name, but that's what it was called. This is not made up. You do need to put it together. There's stickers, there's bands, there's all sorts of things to create this card case gimmick that will do this effect for you. Because of the nature of the card case, it is a gimmick. You would need to leave it dedicated to this, just this one effect. You'll not be able to use that card case and contain a full deck of cards,
No, definitely not, no. And also, you got a question, how long is that going to last?
Yeah, I don't think it's going to last that long. And
not long at all.
Here's the reality. On the trailer, you can't see anything because it's the perfect angle. And it looks perfect. And if you're filming effects for social media, this looks like CGI. It looks brilliant, where you're just tapping something and it changes. So if that's what you want it for stings in between your social media videos, or you want it on your showreel or something like that, you might like these effects and you might want to get it. But I do not believe anybody is going to be able to get and build this gimmick and use it in a real life performance.
No way.
And fool anybody sat around a table in a situation that we are now, Wayne, and I put that down, and straight away you not know there's anything dodgy about that card case.
No, you would see.
You're going to see it straight away. You'll see lines on it that you shouldn't normally see on a card case.
You already said it. It's only going to be good for social media videos. But if you're going to spend that time making it up, you could have done that on some editing technique on your Mac or something.
I think the difference is the focus as a spectator you've got when you're watching the effect. With the froggy thing, I know I keep going back to it, it's kind of like you've put the folded card on there to one side, and if you perform it right with the right attitude, it's like the box isn't even important.
Yeah.
It's like, do you remember that card? You pick it up and all heat's on this card now. And the box isn't important, you're just picking it up. When you're changing something here and you're going, look at that post-it note, bang, and it changes. All the focus is left in this spot. And as a spectator, you're almost challenged to examine this environment and look at it and ascertain what's wrong with this picture. And unfortunately, when you do that, you can see how it's done.
Exactly.
That's why I don't like it. I wish it was made up. If it was made up, I'd have more to offer in the way of a mark, because it is still useful for social media and video presentations.
Other than that, you've got to keep it in a glass cabinet because it's going to get damaged all the time.
How much are you going to give it, Wayne?
25%.
25, yeah. I was going to give it 32% because some of the changes do look incredible. They look brilliant and somebody might find a great use for it on their YouTube channel. So are you looking forward to it? Anything in particular at Blackpool? What's the event you're going to make a beeline for?
You know what? My mate Dave Loosley.
Right, okay.
Yeah, I look forward to his lecture.
You've told me before. I've never seen Dave lecture, but you've told me before he's one of the most creative magicians.
He really is. He was just a teenager when he came to see my lecture.
Yeah.
And I always remember sitting there, he goes, I really want to create stuff that you're creating as well. And I've always stayed friends with him, and he does. He creates some lovely, lovely items.
Well, there is no doubt who I'm looking forward to seeing.
Go on.
The amazing Jonathan. Live. Hashtag legend.
Yeah.
Like, he's coming to the Blackpool Magic Convention and, you know, they're doing some amazing things with the Blackpool Convention. Blackpool is just getting better. And, you know, unfortunately with Magic Live, which used to be my favourite convention in Vegas, it had a little bit of a downturn last year. Vegas, it's still fantastic. But I am hoping that Stan and the team pull it back a little bit because last year's gala show was terrible. But Blackpool is just getting better every single year now. The production involved. I was speaking to Russ Stevens in London recently. He didn't tell me too much because it's all top secret, but what he was saying about the production and the lengths they're going to make these shows better every single year, it is, it's very commendable. And you can see when you go there as a punter, as a gold card registrant, you can see it on the stage. You can see what you're paying for.
Yeah.
When you see the level of production and the video screens they've got there, they really are raising their game now every single year at Blackpool. And when they're bringing legends over like the amazing Jonathan, you have to kind of say, there's my money, take my money, I'm coming up there. There's my gold card registration.
I'm excited about the whole thing. I just got a little bit of a buzz about it again this
year. Yeah, Blackpool really does have the buzz back.
Lots of people talking about it, lots of people posting on social media. It is. You know they're excited about it because now and again, at least within 48 hours, someone posts on the group, the Facebook group. So, who's looking forward to Blackpool? Because they just want to talk about it. They just want to.
It's genuinely exciting. Yeah. And when I was a kid, I remember going to Blackpool for the first time, and a friend of mine, Mick Hanslick, took us up there.
Yeah.
He passed away a couple of years ago, sadly, but. You know, to go there when I was like 14, 15 years old. And I met Harry Blackstone in that horseshoe bit. And it was like I was meeting Dumbledore. I couldn't believe it. Mm. And he was there in person. I remember being this like really shy, introverted young lad going up to Harry Blackstone, like daring approach him. And the same thing with Wayne Dobson as well, like going up and,
yes, actually,
you know, meeting these people, these legends in the flesh. Yeah. And I remember going up to Harry Blackstone and saying, "Mr. Blackstone, are you gonna do the light bulb at the convention?" Because I couldn't believe that there was a chance I was going to see this epic illusion that I'd only ever seen on the Paul Daniels TV show. Because you know, no YouTube in those days, no Harry Blackstone Jr. light bulb illusion. You see it straight away. You had to wait till Christmas till you saw it on television, and you couldn't even record it back in the day. So you'd remembered seeing it on the Paul Daniels show, and you thought, I wonder if he's going to do it live, this incredible effect. And I said, you know, Mr. Blackstone, are you going to do it? And in this gravitas sort of voice, he kind of said to me, well, young man, we need to check the atmospherics in the theatre, and then we'll have to wait and see.
Brilliant.
And I was just like, oh. Still one of the greatest moments of my life, you know, that a performer of this. And, you know, that's probably my greatest Blackpool memory.
Mm.
You know, Pendragon, seeing the substitution trunk for the first time. You know, and I still remember walking out to do their gala show appearance and thinking, crikey, this is it.
Mm.
And obviously personal memories of Blackpool, winning the British Magic Championships, British Champion of Illusion. It will always have a special place in my heart, but it's getting better and better.
There's something about the last couple of years. It's people are talking about it more and they're excited about it. And look at the lineups we're getting as well.
It is. It's amazing. They're doing really great work. Anyway, I'm not sure if this guy's going to be at Blackpool, but I certainly saw him at Magic Live. This is Michael Scanzello, who did a beautiful ring on rubber band, which he showed me in person at Magic Live this year. And to say this guy's a technician is an understatement. He's probably one of the most skilled close-up magicians out there. Mm. But at the same time, he's kind of under the radar because he's only had a couple of products. Super nice guy.
He's just been out there working.
Yeah, just out working the stuff. And you can tell that when you watch this product, which is called Anomaly. It comes with a couple of gaffs with it, a red and a blue gaff.
Yep.
And he does state that the gaff is good for at least 600 performances. And if you get 600 performances out of a jaw-dropping effect like this, you're certainly going to get your money's worth. It's by no means self-working, is it?
No, it's not. But I love stuff like that because I do like a product that comes out and you just have to learn a little bit of sleight of hand, keep remembering where we come from, get some roots out of it, rather than just say, that's how it works. So, you know, it's all very good having stuff like that. But no, this you're going to learn stuff. You're going to learn.
Yeah, it's actually one of those products where if you get it, you learn the techniques involved. Even if you were just learning this trick, you'd actually get a little bit of an education into magic as
well. Exactly. And I love that because as well, what happens is that Michael credits everyone.
Yeah, yeah.
It
there's like
everybody.
There's literally 15 minutes of crediting. But it's interesting. He's got a really good manner about him, and he's a very good teacher. Mm. The way he puts things across, and he does remind me. And this is kind of high praise indeed, but he does remind me a little bit of Mike Lamar, how he teaches and the pace.
Oh, yeah,
and,
I understand what you're saying. Yeah,
and you kind of feel really relaxed while you're watching him go through these.
Why if he was influenced there?
I don't know.
That's a very good point.
The effect is kind of a basic card routine, but it's really hard hitting. Like it says on the front, but it doesn't really do it justice. Change an ace into four kings.
Yeah, that doesn't.
It doesn't do it justice how powerful this effect could be. And there's variations of the effect as well. So the trailer's broke down. The tutorial, rather, is broke down into 90 minutes of tutorial. There's a lot of crediting on there. Then he tells you how to take care of your gaff. And then he breaks down sort of three or four really, really strong effects.
I can't remember the name of the one that I like the most. I mean, they are all very good, but one of them was just, I need to do that.
You,
I need to do it.
You like the one where basically you show a small packet of cards. If you like, you can remove those cards from the deck.
That's what I like, remove them from the deck.
Yeah, you've basically got one ace
and four kings.
Four kings.
Yeah.
And you put the ace into the spectator's
That's
hand.
It, yeah.
So they're holding that one ace. Powerful
and
stuff
then,
coming
yeah.
up here. And now, because of the gaff, and it's a custom printed gaff as well, you are then able to show all four kings, or at least that's what the spectator will remember, because of the custom printed gaffs, in your hand, right before you literally, in one action, change those four kings into the one ace. Now, when they open their hands and spread the cards...
What is stronger than that?
They've got the four kings in their hands.
So they always say, if you end up doing close-up magic for one single person, let the magic happen in their hands. And that is mind-blowing.
There is a reaction on the download with the crowd watching, and they do literally go, whoa. And it is like that, isn't it? Like, literally, there's one ace. I've got four kings here. We might try it with the diamonds, clubs, hearts, spades. But now I've just got the one ace. Open your hand. They've got the four kings. And if you've got the deck set to one side, you can immediately pick everything up, hand them that ace and the four kings. Mm-hmm. And everything's examinable. It's been so well routine. The only thing I do want to stress is, and I did say at the start, it's not self-working. You will need to spend a little bit of time working on this.
Which is a good thing.
But at the end of the day, you are going to get a really strong effect. There's other effects described that use the card box as well.
Yeah.
Like one where he shows, I think he shows the aces turn into the kings. Mm-hmm. No, the kings turn into the aces in his hand. And then he says, well, they must be in the box, and they all go blank in the box or something like that. And the most basic of presentations is the very first trick up on the download, which is kind of like a twisting the aces style routine, where all the kings, one by one, turn face down, and at the end it is revealed that they're all aces. So very, very strong magic here, but for both myself and Wayne, it's all about that effect where you put the one ace in the spectator's hands, and in 1 second... that changes to four kings and you're left with a one ace.
I can't think of something on here. You can easily carry it around with you while you're at a gig. It's for a working material.
It's a little bit angly. It reminds me of the first time I saw NFW. The effect blows you away. Yeah. It's unbelievable. It's got gaffs with it. You might need to replace it after you've renewed it. After each 200 performances, Michael says you need to renew the gaff, which is easily enough done. He explains very clearly how to do that. He says you can renew it up to 3 times. He said it's good enough for 600 performances. And I trust him. And the reason I trust him is because he's got live performances on there and you can see him out there doing it.
You can see he's a worker. You can actually see that he goes out to gigs and does this stuff.
I'm giving it, once again, 95%. What are you giving it, Wayne?
Same as me, 95. I'm going to give it the same.
Yeah, really strong effect.
Brilliant
Put
stuff.
The time in, learning it, and when that spectator opens their hands, they are literally going to be blown away. Thumbtip Ignitor Pro is a new gimmick from Sans Mind's Productions, their creative lab.
Yep.
Very well presented in a lovely carrying case.
Beautiful packaging.
Reminds me very much of the like a mini vapor box. certainly a very, very good quality gimmick that means that you don't really need a lighter anymore to ignite flash paper or flash products. Yeah. If you want to hold it at your fingertips, this gimmick, which is USB rechargeable, will allow you to hold that gimmick, hold the flash paper rather, and at your fingertips, ignite it, and then because of the usual TT subtlety, you will be able to show your hands completely empty at the time that ignition is taking place. Mm. We are both very, very impressed with the build quality of this gimmick.
Beautifully made.
It does work very, very well. Mm. The only negative I would say, that you certainly don't have as a working pro if you're going to use a lighter, and I have a routine that I use. I need to actually still use a lighter because I need the excuse to go to my pocket and do a switch or something. But it is very cool to not have to use a lighter. Yeah. What you're sacrificing there, you're gaining a lot, obviously, by using this gimmick, because it looks a lot more magical. What you're sacrificing is the fact that it's very easy as a worker to just carry a light around, and every single time you want to ignite something, you light it, and that's it during that routine. Yeah. With this, you've got, I want to say, nearly a minute of reset time.
Easy,
because you need to get it out. You need to, first of all, apply some flash wool, and you can't just stuff it in
and
there.
I must say this, a lot of people are scared of setup times anyway, but this requires private setup time, doesn't it?
Yeah, I think you could do it at a gig. I think you could have little bits of flash wool, because first, the gimmick ignites flash wool, which is not supplied. A very small amount of flash wool, which you like twist into the gimmick, and that's what's ignited first, and then that little fireball that comes from your Thumbtip Ignitor Pro, TT Ignitor Pro, then responsible for lighting up the flash paper.
Flash paper, yeah.
But it does need a little bit of reset time. However, I do like the effects which are being put forward in the trailer, the effect that you've got a piece of flash paper, you light it, and at your fingertips you can produce a deck of cards.
Yeah.
I love how they use a flash card on the deck, and he's using the gimmick to ignite the whole piece of flash card, which is on the card box, and then you're getting that trace reveal on there. I think that looks really, really good. As a working pro, I don't think I'd use this, but I'm pleased I've got one, because I think the use for video and social media clips and magical moments that look absolutely great and visually stunning is not really limited.
I like it if you need it for a one-time performance, you know, if you're on stage doing something, or a little close-up set, or maybe a little parlor show that you're doing, and you need a one-off ignition, then great. I don't think I'd want to be setting something up like that.
There's another effect which is taught on the download, which I didn't quite agree with. I thought it was a little bit unethical of Sans Minds. And because it's a marketed gimmick by Magic Smith, right. And they have an effect where they've got like a book of matches, and that book of matches, I think it's called Inferno, but I'm not sure, where the book of matches completely explodes. And although they're using their gimmick, I didn't really agree with them, like, kind of going, this is the same effect, but you can now do it with this gimmick. Mm. I didn't like that about the tutorial. I felt like that, a little bit uncomfortable watching that, because I know that's an established effect on the market by Magic Smith, and I thought they should have left that alone. But other than that, I did like the product.
Yeah, they didn't need to do that.
I like the product a lot, and I think it offers a lot without infringing on somebody else's, you know, inventive rights, even if they found a slightly better, but slightly newer, but certainly not better way of doing it. But the gimmick itself is very good, very sound, very, very well made. The only thing I would say, without giving too much away as well, is the flash wool is ignited from kind of like the pad of the thumb, but you can't see anything. It's like there's nothing in your hands, and it comes from this area of your thumb just here. I would have liked it a little bit more if it came a little bit further forward, because it does mean that you need to hold these objects, like this flash paper, way back in your fingertips, like this. It would be nicer if you could hold it a little bit more naturally with just the tip of your thumb holding that object. That's very small negatives. I did really like it. I'm pleased that I've got one. It's a lot better than I thought it was going to be, and very, very well made, which is why I'm going to give it exactly 91%.
Lovely. I mean, it is very well made. I've got to say, it's incredible. The packaging's lovely, as you'd expect, I guess, from Sands Mines. I can't see myself using it because I, for the same reason of using a lighter, is the same reason I need to use it. Yeah. I have to use a lighter to for the effect that I use for it to work, and it wouldn't work with that. However, yeah, I've got to do the same kind of 87%.
Yeah, it's not a bad product, and if you like the effects on there, you're not going to be disappointed when you get your gimmick. It's not the cheapest thing, but when you get the gimmick, you open it up, the money's inside the box. You can see what you're paying for. It is a great product from Sands Mines. A really, really good product. And I'm sure there'll be more great products at Blackpool, because it's not too far away now. As you can tell from this week's show, we're getting very excited for the world's largest magic convention. We're going to see you there. You've got your new product.
Yeah,
I've got my new one. Only 60 available, though. We're looking forward to sharing those with you on next time's Wizard Product Review. Until then, I'm Dave.
I'm Wayne.
And we'll see you next time on the Wizard Product Review.